Hi everyone, hope you're all doing well. I'm Gabriel, I'm a structural engineer, and continuing on from part two of this four-part series, today we're gonna go over load case. So I'll show you how you can apply dead loads and live loads, and we'll have a quick look at deflection and bending moment diagrams, and finally we're gonna run a wind load simulation. Let's get into it. All right, our structure is looking good. So it's time to apply some loads. Go to load types, define the nature and the name of the loads. I'm creating dead and live loads for roof and floor. So we have here dead load for the roof. Just click add. Let's do a live load for let's do a live load for the floor, and then just click add. And just do the same procedure for all dead loads and live loads for roof and floors. Just click add and then click close. On this drop down menu, select the floor dead load case and then select the floor framing for the bottom module and isolate it. So it's going to make it easier to visualize. Select the panels and on load definition, I'm going to choose surface, uniform planar loads, and then minus 1 kPa at global Z direction. With the panel selected, select click apply. You can verify if the loads have been applied by turning load symbols on. Now let's repeat the same process for the floor of the top module. So select the floor framing, isolate them, and select again only the panels. On load definition, let's apply the same minus 1 kPa to the panels. Turn load symbols on and double check if the loads have been assigned properly. Now let's apply the roof dead load. Alright, so select all the roof panels and now I'm going to use 0.15 kPa surface load. So just go 0.15 kPa minus 0.15. I selected the roof beams by accident. So now I'm gonna select only the roof panels. Just select all the roof panels and then click apply. Cool, the dead loads have been applied. Now let's jump to live loads. Starting with the floor panels of the bottom module. Let's just select all the panels of the bottom module. And I'm going to apply a surface area of 1.5 kPa, minus 1.5 kPa. Okay, cool. So now I'm going to isolate the top module floor framing just to make it easier to visualize. I think that's a bad idea. You got to make something to just to make easier for you to see all the members that you're applying the loads. That's why you add it in a new window. So here's the same 1.5 kPa for floor live loads. Now the Roof panels will be subjected to a 0.25 kPa live load. So let's select them all. Here, all the roof panels. And let's apply minus 0.25 kPa. Add and apply. Okay, let's run an analysis to see if our model presents any errors or if we get any message from robot. Let's just go and click in calculations. And so you've got a message in blue, and it's just a warning saying that the claddings haven't been assigned any thickness, and a finite element mesh has not been generated. Which is fine because we're not designing the panels. So that's not an issue. So from here, we can check the results in diagram for bars. In parameters, change the description to labels and filling to filled. And we can have a quick look at the deflection of the structure. Let's normalize the scale, turn off section shape. And you can notice here that my largest deflection under roof live load is 5 millimeters. And you can isolate the elements to check them separately, if you will. So the deflections will change according to the load case you're analyzing. So I've got dead loads, live loads, and then you've got your deflection changing. So you can play around with deflections. Have a look how the structure deforms for different load cases. If you're already getting excessive deflections for dead load, for instance, you can expect an even higher deflection under a load combination. Hence, you can start considering upsizing sections or reducing spans. You can check bending moment diagrams. Make sure the shape of the diagrams looks like what you were expecting. Soon after we define our load combinations, we can go through stresses and shear and axial force diagrams as well. Okay, now let's go over a wing load simulation. Turn panels interiors on, go to loads, wing load simulation, and generate wing loads. Here you have the options to choose wind directions. The parameters such as wind velocity or wind pressure. For instance, let's say 30 meters per second. And then in wind exposure, we're gonna select all the panels. Just right click on the panel, select similar, and select by thickness. Now just copy and paste the elements from here to here. And click start. Now just let robot do its magic, and based on the 30 meters per second wind speed, you're already able to picture how the pressures will be distributed by watching this simulation. It's pretty cool. You can also get the wind loads from AS1170.2 and make a comparison between both pressures. That would be a pretty interesting homework for you to do. Even though you should check wind for other directions, for learning purpose, as you can see, I simulated wind coming from only one direction. All right, the simulation is completed. Let's have a look at the pressure maps. Select Wind X in the drop-down. Turn load symbols on. And you'll have a pretty good idea of how the pressures are distributed. For instance, there's a maximum of 0.81 kPa acting on the windward wall, and it could go to a negative pressure of minus 0.81 kPa at some areas. So this was the end of our third video of this four-part series in Autodesk Robot. We've got the last video coming up, and I'm gonna show you how to analyze the how to see deflections and bending moment diagrams, shear force diagrams, axial force diagrams, have a look at the stresses, and that's pretty much it. If you have any questions or would like to add something, just drop a comment below. If you like the video, consider giving it a thumbs up, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.